Hey guys, how is everyone doing? I am DCSK. In this video, I want to show you guys a build with Moon Dagger, a very fast attack speed weapon but not fast as Fighter's Binding, and it is not a recommended endgame weapon. Anyway, I will make the best build with it. It is requested by E with unique gears only. Oh, by the way, I'll make a lot of powerful build. You can check out the link at right top here and down there at the description. Alright, let's get into it. For melee weapon, use Moon Dagger, a dual wield weapon, looks cool huh? And at one soul gathering, it has built in level 1 Enigma Resonator. It has 0 to 15% chance to deal triple damage based on the number of soul you have. With critical hit, you have 20% chance to deal triple damage. Next is committed to deal 100% more damage against already wounded enemies. And last is Radiance. Has 20% chance to spawn a circular area that heals you and all allies within the area. For armor, use full metal armor. It has abilities of increased 30% melee damage, 30% to negate damage, 35% damage reduction. You need all these and 100% longer roll cooldown. Don't worry, it is not going to affect much. With chilling to slow down nearby enemies' movement and attack speed by 60%, in a way, you are receiving slightly less damage. Next is Deflect, has 45% chance to deflect incoming projectile. And last is Potion Barrier. Whenever you use health potion, it greatly reduces damage taken by 90% for 9 seconds to protect you when you are in danger or fighting against tough enemies. For Artifact, use Deathcap Mushroom to increase maximum attack speed to slash faster. Next is Satchel of Elixir, brew 2 random potions when activated. And last is Gong of Awakening. Use it when you are fighting against tough enemies like Enchanted Monster, Creeper, Raid Captain and bosses so that you can melt them in a second. Combo with a ranged weapon, Nocturnal Bow is a good choice. It has abilities of add 1 soul gathering and built in level 1 tempo death. Every time you shoot will steal 17% of mob movement speed and give it to you for 4 seconds so you can walk slightly faster. With Burst Bow Strength, every time you roll, it will fire charge shoot to nearby 3 enemies. Next is Enigma Condu. For each soul you absorb, it will heal you 6% of max health. Total up you will add 3 for each soul gathered, so you can store up soul faster and ready to deal more triple damage from Enigma Resonator. And last is Cooldown Shoot. Every time you attack with charge shoot, your artifact cooldown time are decreased. Alright, once you have everything, straight to the battlefield before dive into group of enemies. Make sure to brew 2 potions with Satchel of Elixir to temporarily boost up your hero stat and active mushroom all the time to have maximum attack speed so you can proc Radiance more often to heal you up while fighting against enemies. And don't forget to use Gong of Awakening when you meet tough enemies to melt them. If you see ranged enemies, just walk like a boss, cause you have 45% chance to deflect incoming projectile back to them. And every monster you eliminate will spawn a soul for you. Each soul you absorb will heal you up. It is a backup heal so you won't die easily. In case of emergency, don't forget to use health potion when you are fighting against tough enemies to active potion barrier for stone skin. Do not worry about artifact cooldown time, burst bow strength and cooldown shoot in your bow will do the job. Just keep on rolling when you are fighting and the artifact will be ready in no time. The attack area of this weapon is very small, it is better to add some area of effect enchantment to increase the area damage. But Shockwave and Swirling is not recommended, as the combo length is kinda long, it has 6 combo length, so you will proc lesser of it. The best choice is Thunder Ring as the weapon attack speed is very fast, so you will have higher chance to call the thunder to strike nearby enemies. If you have a gilded one, you can add thundering or sacrifice critical hit to thundering if you have only unique one. If you have thundering on your weapon, don't forget to use lightning focus on your armor to increase the lightning damage. Farm a gilded armor or sacrifice chilling to lightning focus for unique armor. And it is good to go, okay? For this build, you can deal nearly 700,000 damage and as high as 2 million critical damage. With Gong of Weakening, it deals about 6 million critical damage. Add on with Strength Potion, it deals about 10 million critical damage. You can also deal 130 million jackpot critically damage with Gong, Strength and Shadow Potion. Then proc Enigma Resonator and critical hit at the same time. Whew, crazy man. But it is very hard to deal this jackpot critically damage as the chances to proc Enigma Resonator and critical hit at the same time is very low. but you can proc a lot of critical hit with these two enchantments. Bing bing bong bong bing bong bong. You will hear a lot of this sound. Anyway, you still can proc the jackpot critical damage. Just keep on brew potion from Satchel of Elixir and you will be able to hit this. Overall, this weapon is not the best, but you still can beat Apocalypse plus 25 with just unique gears. Also works very well in Instant Hunt. If you are looking for easy way to farm Gilded Gears, I'll make a full playlist of it. You can check out the link at right top here and down there at the description. Alright guys, I hope you all enjoy this Moon Dagger build, slash all the enemies into slices. If you have any question or suggestion, you can leave a comment below. You can also hit me up at my Discord community, everyone is welcome to join. And if you enjoy my content, make sure to hit the subscribe and like button, it is free and it will help me a lot and I am really appreciated. So happy slashing, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.